Formula One returns to Monte Carlo once again today, home to the world-famous Monte Carlo Casino, first opened in 1863. And, of course, a certain road race, first held here in 1929. There's no greater an occasion, no more valuable a win than the Monaco Grand Prix. We're on the French Riviera once more this weekend at the 2-mile-long Circuit de Monaco. The cars climb around 40 meters up through Beau Rivage, onto the casino, and then descending down towards the harbor through Sector 2. It's a very short run from pole position to the first of the 19 corners here, 7 to the left and 11 to the right. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Verstappen, Alexander Albon, and Vettel, Ricciardo, Perez, Stroll, and Esteban Ocon, Kvyat, Norris, the owner driver, and Grosjean, Magnussen, Giovinazzi, Kimi Raikkonen, and Pierre Gasly, Schumacher, Sainz. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Russell and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
race over, take care of the car on the way in.
Great effort there from Ferrari to take the victory today. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
Ferrari are at it again, an excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Our championship leader not only managed to hold on to the top spot, but managed to further extend their lead. Impressive stuff. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Anthony Davidson, who do you pick? It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. Another team that excelled today was Williams, who make further progress up the table. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Pretty happy with that. It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? That was a close finish. How are things between the two of you? Well, that's everything.